So you think you can't develop software, but you've heard that AI can make it easier for you. We have the Pacific Northwest's greatest realtor, now developer, coming to the Cozy AI Kitchen. Stay tuned. So you are a realtor, an accountant, you're someone with a profession, and you would like to know how to build an app, but you think you can't do it. Well, I lucked out because I discovered Chef Gallmeyer out in the Whidbey Island area, who I believe is the Pacific Northwest's greatest realtor, if not now, for years to come. Chef Gallmeyer, welcome to the stage.
Hey, John, thank you for having me.
Thank you for being here. So like, I feel lucky that I began the process and you came into my inbox and I discovered how good you were with ChatGPT and these kind of things. When did you start using these tools?
So I started using these tools when I first started real estate, because a lot of people didn't actually. So it was kind of like my way to get a leg up.
Well, I know that immediately when I was interacting with you, I was like, wow, you noticed that sometimes it makes a mistake. And you said that, and I realized, wow, you are really an expert in AI in many ways. And then we sat down and you described the kind of app you wanted to make for you as a realtor. Can you describe that?
Yeah, so I wanted to make an app that kind of displayed, it's like a CRM, which is displays your current pipelines and kind of like your tasks for the day. But I wanted to up it a little bit and add some AI like tools that you can have to save time, like a property search tool, a comparative market analysis tool, which kind of pulls the information. Or so basically you put a property into it and then it pulls like property similarities and kind of gives you an estimated range of what you're supposed to do or what that price is going to be. And usually it takes a lot of time for me to do that on my own and kind of find the properties. But I wanted to make AI so that it does it for you instead of having to take all that time. So,
and when you were younger, you were using Scratch. So you understood the computer programming.
Yeah. When I was younger, I was using Scratch to Scratch and like code.org and all that stuff in like elementary school. And then I stopped doing it after I went to high school because I didn't take any classes like that, but it was still fun and I got the basics down.
And you did get the top real estate score. I didn't want to humble brag a second. And so you're 19, you figured things out, you've built time to spend basically a few weeks in your app. Let's just see what you've cooked up.
All right, so the first thing that I wanted to add were these upcoming pipelines and under contract pipelines. Now, I already have an app that does this, but I wanted it to still all be in the same place so that I could see it on a daily basis.
Can you help us understand? You described how the app you're using right now is for both buyers and the seller realtors, but you wanted it to be for you.
Yeah. So when I'm on my CRM right now, it shows all information for everybody, sellers, buyers, and everything. And right now I predominantly work with buyers. So I wanted to make something that was either assisting the buyer or assisting the seller. You got to pick which way it went.
So you wanted to customize it to your own way of working.
Yeah, I wanted to make my own thing. And so I added these four things to start, which is the tasks, the upcoming events, the upcoming client pipeline, and the under contract pipeline. And what I wanted to do with these is, with the upcoming events, I wanted it to be attached to your Gmail. Or not your Gmail, your Google Calendar, so that when you added something into your calendar, it would automatically add into the events here so that you could see it. And then I also wanted to add, this is just a task, like kind of knock off your task, daily list kind of thing. And then the upcoming clients pipeline, that one is where you add your clients, and then it ranks them off of the timeline that they're in. So if you put 1 month, they're going to be at the top. You put 6 months, they're going to be lower on the list.
And it actually works.
Yeah.
And you built a database to serve this as well.
Yeah. I mean, I don't fully understand the database, but I did.
You connected it in.
Yeah, it did work.
You had a PostgreSQL running, and I was, at first I thought it was just you made the kind of prototype picture, but you built all the functionality.
Yeah, and you can add their criteria in here too. And so the reason I added that, so that you can put their criteria in there, is so that you can take that, copy and paste it, and then put it into the property search over here. And then it'll eventually, once it starts working, it'll use AI to pull all the information and then find similarities for that criteria, and also a little bit higher, a little bit lower, so that you're not just stuck in that range.
And you are you now have a GitHub account. It's 2 weeks old. You have a repo you're developing with. And then we talked about APIs, and you quickly thought about how to call APIs through that search. Can you describe that?
Yeah. So when I was trying to work it out, at first, I didn't know anything about that. And then after our conversation at Starbucks that first day, I kind of did a little bit more research. And then I figured out if you plug an API in and then you ask it to call on that API, it actually uses the information from the API. And then you can use that for your app.
And Brandon, API wasn't a word you were using 3 weeks ago, I believe.
No, it's not a word I knew existed.
As an expert in realty, by the way, best realtor. So this is expert in that. You quickly switched, brought your scratch knowledge into this, and you also added AI to your app.
Yeah. So I added AI through OpenAI API. And so basically this is, you can tailor it to the buyer or the seller.
Oh, you added that. That's amazing.
Yeah. And so you can ask a question like, what would closing costs? $700,000 loan.
And you also have the waiting spinner there too.
Yeah.
The craft that you have brought to this app is extraordinary.
And then boom. It gives you the answer, what you're looking for. Right. So that you don't have to do a whole bunch of research on it. If it's a quick question that you just want to, if a client asks you and you're on the phone, you can type that in real quick and then give them that answer while they're on the phone so that you don't have to hang up and then get it to them later.
And then you also added a social media post generator?
Yeah. So the social media creator is, you choose the platform over here. Like if you wanted to post it on Instagram, you chose the post type and then it comes from all of these drop downs.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go with like a client testimonial. And then you describe what you want it to be. And then you press generate post. You can also add your hashtags that your brands use. And then it'll automatically generate a post with the captions and everything that you need to copy and paste and just paste it into whatever platform that you're using.
What's impressed me is your command of the practice of being a realtor and bringing it to software development. Like most people aren't a realtor and they make the software for the realtor. You are a realtor and you're making software for yourself and possibly other people too.
Yeah, well, I made it like that because I want to make my life as easy as possible, because if I can use AI in as many things as I can, granted that it doesn't always work, so I don't want to rely on that fully, but if I can use it to the best of my abilities to help me, why not?
I mean,
basically the future.
Basically the future from the future. And can you bring up the main screen again? I love the story you tell about how you showed your grandfather or uncle the screen.
Yeah, so I was showing my grandpa the app and I went over to appearance, and originally I had it in this dark mode where you could switch the different colors and apply purple, rose, and emerald. Those are the four that I picked right now. And I was showing my grandpa and he was having a trouble reading the screen.
Hmm.
And so he was like, you need a light mode. And I kid you not, it was the hardest thing to do, but adding a light and dark mode in there.
My gosh, it's beautiful. It's also sensitive to what people want. It's built on your expertise. I think that, as I said to you when you first showed this to me, just days after you had your first GitHub identity, you have extraordinary skills. So for all of you out there inspired by Chef Gallmeyer right now, can you tell people what it is that you would like them to know about who you are, what you want to do, and what others can do like this?
Well, I'm just a realtor that's trying to make the best that I can do. And one thing that you should do is always look into what you can do to improve and what resources there are out there, like AI. There's a bunch of resources out there that you may not know about that you can use to improve your craft. So that's really all I'm trying to do, is be the best that I can be.
Chef Gallmeyer, you give me like Sir Goose. I'm sorry. You're thank you for bringing your cooking to this kitchen. And I hope that all of us can learn that anything is possible with extraordinary mind. So, well, thanks for tuning in. And there'll be more cooking in the future too. See ya.